For years, Korea had served as the most dominant region in all of competitive League of Legends. Teams like Samsung Galaxy and SK Telecom T1 had controlled the professional stage with a vice grip, winning every world championship for the LCK between 2013 and 2017. For 5 straight years, Korea had been on top of the world. But during that span, teams from China such as Edward Gaming, RNG, and World Elite were always a consistent threat on the international stage. Even though China was a constant thorn in the side of the Korean juggernauts, the LPL was never truly able to rise to the top. The region had managed to lock down the title of second best. So when Invictus Gaming captured glory at the 2018 World Championship, giving China its first ever Summoner's Cup, it's safe to say the LPL was truly legitimized as a region. In the span of just one season, the LPL went from a perennial contender to snatching the crown. The LPL's upward trend continued in 2019 when the region secured back-to-back Worlds titles through the efforts of a team that practically emerged from thin air. FunPlus Phoenix, a team that had struggled heavily throughout its young history in competitive League of Legends, found itself scrambling for answers after a 2018 season in which the organization finished 8th in the LPL standings. The one-year-old franchise sat back and watched China rise to the top of the world thanks to the achievements of Invictus Gaming. So prior to the 2019 season, FPX made the decision that they wanted to compete right alongside LPL royalty. The organization made 2 massive additions to its starting lineup in free agency, 2 additions that would inevitably propel the team straight to the top of the LPL. FPX added former Rogue Warriors mid laner Doinbi and former Suning jungler Tien into the mix, supporting a roster that had already shown signs of development during the 2018 season. With several major splashes in free agency, FunPlus Phoenix transformed from a middle-of-the-road contender into a championship-ready team overnight. For FPX, those free agent signings came to fruition in a 2019 season that was, in a word, dominant. The team was able to combine the talents of established players such as Gimgoon, Crisp, and LWX with the eyebrow-raising moments brought by newcomers in Tien and Doinbi. FunPlus won 30 of its 34 matches on the domestic stage in 2019, good enough for a winning percentage of 88%. The team ripped through the LPL's other contenders throughout the season, establishing themselves as the strongest contender that the region had to offer. The team's star mid laner, Doinbi, was able to win the LPL's MVP award for the spring season, while Tien and LWX were named to the region's All-Pro team after securing the summer title. Just 1 year removed from scraping the floor of the LPL, FunPlus Phoenix was heading into the 2019 World Championship on top of the game's most dominant region by an incredibly wide margin. As the number one seed from China, the team was poised to build upon the legacy that Invictus Gaming had established just 1 year prior. It was time for the LPL to continue its reign of dominance with FunPlus Phoenix at the wheel. But still, heading into Worlds 2019, no one truly expected the LPL champions to make a whole lot of noise at the tournament. Instead, the narrative was focused more on the region's biggest rivals. Teams like Griffin and SK Telecom T1 were drawing massive amounts of attention, as 2019 was supposed to be the year where the LCK was going to climb back to the top of the game's international mountain. Even Europe was garnering respect, as a Worlds Finals appearance from Fnatic the previous year put the LEC back on the map. If anything, FPX and the rest of the LPL were quickly becoming an afterthought, despite the region's decisive victory at the tournament just 1 year prior. But FPX came prepared to silence any doubters. The team blazed through the world's group stage, finishing at the top of Group B and breezing past opponents such as Splice, J-Team, and the Gigabyte Marines to head straight into the quarterfinals. What awaited them on the other side, though, was a mountain of proven opponents. FPX's bracket run may have been one of the toughest roads to a championship the professional League of Legends had ever seen up to that point. By facing off against Fnatic in the quarterfinals and IG in the semis, FunPlus had to take down both the 2018 champions and runners-up to merely make it to the finals. They did so by the way of 2 clean 3-1 victories, setting up a date with Europe's super team, G2 Esports. In the grand finals, the LPL champs squared off head-to-head with a G2 squad that was being penciled in by seemingly everyone to walk away with the Summoner's Cup. Facing off against the supposed tournament favorite in their home region is never an easy task, but FPX rose to the occasion.
Zendrus comes in, Doinbi is chasing forward. That's already a kill onto Yankos. This could be it! Now Wonder's in trouble as Caps goes golden under the hourglass. He needs to do so much more. Will throw down the Event Horizon, but it doesn't matter. 2 members of G2 are left to fend off 4 from FunPlus Phoenix.
FPX are headed straight for that Nexus, and it's only Wonder and Perks left standing.
In a convincing 3-0 victory, FunPlus Phoenix secured the 2019 World Championship over G2, silencing the crowd. Not just in Paris, but around the world. In one of the most dominant series in League of Legends history across the board, every member of FPX came to play that day against G2. AD carry LWX posted a scoreline of 21-0-14 across the 3 games, while Gimgoon's series KDA of 32.0 capped off an incredible tournament for the top laner. And of course, Tien's cross-map dominance helped secure tournament MVP for FPX's prize jungler. The statement victory capped off a 32-6 run for FPX at the back end of 2019, one of the best stretch runs to end a season in the game's history. But ever since the organization rose to the top of the international scene just over 1 year ago, things haven't exactly gone smoothly. FPX's road to a repeat in 2020 was filled with obstacles as the organization failed to qualify for the 2020 World Championship and a chance to defend their title. The team's addition of LCK veteran Khan in the top lane only muddied the water surrounding FPX's starting lineup, while players such as Doinbi and Tien weren't able to match their throughput from the 2019 season. In 2020, FPX became the sixth team to fail to qualify for Worlds the season after winning the entire tournament. Subsequently, China's dreams of a regional three-peat were axed by Damwon Gaming, bringing Korea back to the top of the international scene. But even now, heading into 2021, FPX's championship roster still stands strong. Four out of the five starters who took the team to the top of the world in the first place still remain with the organization. Perhaps even more notably, the team was able to make a massive free agency splash this past offseason, just as they did in 2019. FunPlus boosted its starting lineup by signing world champion top laner Nuguri away from Damwon Gaming. Still complemented by the ever-threatening jungle mid duo of Tien and Doinbi, as well as the now impeccably experienced bottom lane of LWX and Crisp, FPX once again stands firm, ready to take the world by storm. Just over a year removed from the title run that shook all of China as well as the entirety of the world to its core, FunPlus Phoenix is poised to return to the top of professional league in a fiery blaze of glory.